pull right in front of Stone Creek and our building and never have to cross a street. If it remains in front of Ruckus, or if it remains in front of our stop, then we have parents parking in front of Ruckus and crossing the street with their children. It's already something that concerns me with the parking deck, but being that there's a crosswalk there and it's just directly across Oakland, it's mitigated. But having that bus stop moved to the north would really substantially mitigate any children going across streets to go to or from school, if that's the traffic concern. Parents are also going to be able to drop off in the parking lot as well, because the bank doesn't even open until 9 a.m. Our parents drop off, the height of the drop off is between 7:30 and 8:30 in the morning, which is before the bank opens. So, I'm sorry, ma'am?
And the pickup?
The pickup is the only portion that'll be questionable, because if Ruckus opens at 3, I don't know how busy they are. I've tried sitting across from them, and I've seen some nights where they're completely empty and other nights where they're, you know, busy. Talking to Mod Pizza, they're fully supportive. Everyone local that I've discussed this with has been on their sound board and excited for this to come to the community. But believing parking and child safety is paramount, so.
Can I get a quick clarification? I was talking about the street, the children live on the street. There are a lot of families on the street.
Right, and I saw that when I walked through the community. It's not your street exclusively, it's every street in the Shoreway community, which is why this is a great community to open in. It's a one-way street. I can't imagine on Wood.
No.
I would love it.
Parking one side.
Yeah, parking one side.
And it's very, it's pretty much impossible for two cars to pass each other. Can you go up?
Can I come up actually too? My name is Frank Kunick. I live at 1811 Wood. And my biggest thing, like.
Just talking to my phone again.
All right. Dr. Rupel mentioned several things that she's concerned about, as am I. But the biggest one is traffic. And it has nothing to do with Casa de Corazon, but it does have to do with the area. You have added a Metro Market. Ms. Miller already mentioned the exception you made for Ruckus. You added a couple extra floors to the apartment complex that was built. So you're doing all these things to increase traffic, but what has been done to alleviate traffic or deal with that? So my biggest concern isn't a weed or, well, I guess it's a bus, but there are children on our street, and people turn off of Oakland and turn onto Wood and go very quickly. You know, they speed up very quickly, and there's something that was mentioned earlier was an enforcement issue. Well, yeah, state law is to let pedestrians cross the road, but if you try to cross Oakland there, you're risking your life. And I know this because I do it every day. And that's definitely a different issue, but something that we need to be considered with the big picture. So, suggestion thrown out would be to make Wood and or Kenmore one-way streets. Like Allendale is 3 blocks south, it's a one-way street going east. So that's Allendale. Jarvis is the block south, then you have Kenmore, then Allendale. So Allendale is one-way street going east. So something like that would hopefully be a good solution, but yeah, because we have nothing against Casa de Corazon, correct?
I think it's a great idea.
Yeah. Oh yeah, we travel the world and we see kids who oftentimes are translators for their parents. So teaching U.S. kids Spanish is a wonderful thing. But yeah, we just have concerns about the traffic. I mean, along with Dr. Rupel's other concerns, but so that's what we would like to, or I would like to address or have discussed.
Thank you.
I'm sorry, Frank, how do you spell your last name?
K-U-N-I-K.
Thank you.
The only thing I have to say on that, ma'am, is by eliminating that northern exit out of the parking lot, it would be substantially less traffic leaving Wells, Stone Creek, and our location. Because the only exit option is to the south onto Jarvis. That's really the only way I can see to mitigate that from my point. As far as people speeding and potentially hitting kids and it being dangerous, like I understand as a parent of two young kids, but that's not something that me as a business I can necessarily mitigate. That would be on law enforcement.
Thank you. Is there any other people in the audience that would like to make any comments or ask any questions before we open it to commissioners? Okay, so I'll close the public hearing at this time. Thank you all. And I will open it up to the commissioners for questions. Commissioner Miller?
In Bart's memo, he mentioned that he already gave you a heads up about probably some of the main concerns, parking, traffic, and the placement of the play area. I would also add the school security and safety of the kids on that list. So I don't know, President Rosak, if you want to take those one subject at a time, or should we just throw all our questions out? Because we might all have questions on parking, we might all have questions on the traffic.
Yeah, great question. I think we should take them by topic. But before we do, I forgot to ask, was there any emails? I didn't receive any. I just want to make sure there was no other public input that you had received or that any of us have received. That's fine. Okay. So going with that, if the commissioners are okay with this, why don't we, Bart, would you like to suggest the first topic as for us to ask questions on?
Sure. I guess we can go, if we have any other, go in order of the first one that I mentioned.
And is there anything to say what we should be focusing on?
The parking would be guided by the special exception standards. Correct. Yes. So
parking circulation. What else? I just want to make sure we're not
up here. The things I've given them the heads up on, quote unquote, was parking, traffic, circulation, the location and operations of the outdoor play area. Those are the three that I have given a heads up on, so if you'd like to take them in that order, you can take whatever you like, but.
Is safety something that, I'm just asking before I put it on the list, is that something that we can take into consideration based on our conditions that they have to meet?
I guess I need further clarification on.
Well, of course, school safety is a major issue across the country. And so as we look at the site plan, I have some questions about how parents are entering and exiting, you know, who has entrance to the building. And also, you mentioned a fence going on the north and southern ends of the play area. So that answered one question. But again, access to and from the building, you know, is there a locked vestibule? Anybody walking out the street, you've got the fence right there next to the window. So just in general, how that
will work. Thank you. So fence and pedestrian circulation. Go ahead. Attorney Garrett.
Thank you. I was just going to mention that keep in mind that you're considering two different things. One is the conditional use permit. In other words,
right,
what can physically go in that space? Is that a type of use that's appropriate for this particular area? Separate from that, now that that type of business can be allowed in there, are you going to grant them a special exception where they don't have to otherwise conform to the parking requirements that would come with that type of business? So to your question on public health and safety, the first criteria under the conditional use permit talks about finding that the establishment, maintenance, or operation of the conditional use, if granted, would not be detrimental to or endanger the public's health, safety, morals, comfort, and welfare. So if there's specific questions relating to the use versus specific questions relating to the parking, you may want to bring two separate motions just so that the record is a little cleaner and then you've got findings related to each. I'll just give a suggestion.
Okay, so can we start with the special use to determine if the use is appropriate for the space? And that would be 535-25, review and approval of conditional uses. So you have 1 through 7 conditions that we have to consider. Let's take safety first. So the questions on safety, establishment or maintenance for operations, conditions are not detrimental to safety. Commissioner Miller.
I can say a couple questions. The fencing, it may have answered one of them, because my concern was keeping the kids in the play area from dashing out into that parking area and preventing strangers off the street or in the parking area from coming into the play area or entering the school. Maybe, I don't know how many teachers would be out at a time, but again, we got like little toddlers running around. And also so they could be dashing out onto Wood or in the parking lot, and also just people having access to the building. You know, I think our, some of our grade schools are like, look, it's not locked, parents are not allowed in during the day. So that seems to me to be a public health and safety issue. I'm just wondering how that would be addressed.
Do you want to approach that?
Sure.
So according to DCF 251, which is the governing document for Department Schultz Family with large childcare centers, the 5-foot fence is what the requirement is. It'll be a nice fence. It's not going to be anything that kids can climb nor go out through between the bars or anything like that. As far as access to the building, we do have a vestibule that also has a receptionist sitting right on the outside, as well as our two administrator offices. Each parent is issued two key cards to access the building. So to come in and out of, or to come into the building and drop off your children, you need one of those cards. If you do not have one of those cards, you have to be on an access list. So you ring a bell, they allow you in, you prove with your identification that you are on that child's pickup list or drop off list. And that way you have access to that child. If you're not someone that the center director or the staff feels comfortable with, they are more than entitled to call the parents and verify that you are who you say you are and that you have access to that child. Otherwise, no one else is going to have access to that building other than parents. A lot of mothers, especially young mothers with, you know, young mothers of young children at the current centers do like to come in throughout the day and nurse. So they'll come in around lunchtime, they'll nurse their child, and then go back to work. So they would obviously have access to do that. But as far as security is concerned, the key card at the front door, the vestibule, the staff members are multiple layers of security, as well as having cameras in every hallway, at every entrance and exit, and every classroom. So it's as secure as I can imagine.
And then in the play area, is there any emergency exit? Let's say there's a fire in the building and that's the only exit. It's to have the kids through their gates or something so you can exit that way.
Yeah, we'll speak on that. This is my architect from Growth Design and Seaver.
Peter Anstar, 11739 North Shore Cliff Lane. There is an emergency egress out into the park play area out of the building. It meets all code requirements or area of refuge, so you can get away from the building per building codes. I would say that I'm certainly not an expert in school security or daycare security, but DCF does set the governing bodies, which really draw all their criteria for both safety and egress out of the building.
Staff member, teacher couldn't open that up, but a 4-year-old couldn't open it up and dash out into the street.
Just a point of order, if the commissioner
leaves, we'll do. I'd like to know
that. I think they did that. Just ask every college.
Put a personal order.
I think he's coming back, right?
Mm-hmm. I don't know.
He's coming back.
I guess so.
He ran downstairs for a moment.
For that.
we still have a forum.
Okay.
I guess it would be up to you if you run as the ahead of the meeting if, you know.
I didn't know if it has to be written in it, sir.
Anything to take a pause from the evidence or if you wanted to keep have something filmed and get back. Up to you.
Does anyone mind taking a 3-minute recession? Sorry about that. Good. Yeah. Thank you.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you.